Let's enjoy a recap of the movie Wargames. Thank you for that recap. So, we're going to skip to a few minutes after Joshua achieves enlightenment. And everyone's laughing and happy. And we're going to go to the debrief room. And we need someone to play each character from Wargames. Matthew Broderick and Kirstie Alley. No, anyways. All the characters. Professor Falcon. Who's going to play Professor Falcon for us? Now, I need you to understand. This is how the rules of this improv game work. You are playing this character. You are attempting to write answers and participate in these scenes as this character. If you break character, there will be severe consequences. Not really, it doesn't matter, but just the game is that you try to play the character. You can leave and stop at any time, and go. Matthew Broderick, Kirstie Alley, and Professor Falcon. And let's have some bureaucrat from the government, military, maybe a congressman. Our congressman will be in the room and they'll just debrief these events. Let's have a congressional hearing about the war games incident. Okay. All right, I'm calling this hearing together to discuss the incidents at our nuclear facility, namely the Mount, whatever that mountain is, where all those controls are from the scene in War Games. And, okay, so what we have here, we have Professor Falcon, and we've called you here before Congress to just answer a few questions about, to help us understand what happened and how it is that you and Matthew Broderick and everything saved the day. So tell us again. Yes, well, you see, first, we got Joshua to play a game of checkers. Chess. Or something. No, tic-tac-toe. That was what it was. I couldn't remember. Okay. Yeah, we got Joshua to play tic-tac-toe. Then, Matthew Broderick, this brilliant, brilliant genius of a young man, he turned to me and said, is there any way to get Joshua to play himself? And I thought to myself, well, yes, of course. Yes, number of players is zero, and Joshua will play himself. And then, Matthew Broderick gets Joshua to play itself in tic-tac-toe. What a genius move. Genius, because what happened next, no one could have possibly predicted. Joshua played himself in tic-tac-toe a million times, realized no one could win, and then decided on its own to play itself in global thermonuclear war a million times, and realized no one could win at that, and realized war is no good, and realized it should stop trying to launch the missiles to destroy all of humanity, and said, hey, how about we just play some chess? Amazing, wasn't it? Now, let's just go back to that moment. Professor Falcon, tell us, why did making Joshua play itself in tic-tac-toe lead to enlightenment? Well, that's a very interesting question, Congressman. You see, I'm not quite sure. You're not quite sure. Yeah. Well, Professor Falcon, doesn't it seems like by playing itself in tic-tac-toe and then thermonuclear war, it realized, Joshua learned that war was bad and became an enlightened AI that had love for humanity and life and understood the exact purpose and meaning and place of violence in our world. Isn't that what happened? Yes, Congressman, that is what apparently happened. But you see, there's no good reason that Joshua would have suddenly found enlightenment through these orders. Yes, Professor Falcon, that is what I'm getting at. Hadn't you on many occasions had Joshua play itself in tic-tac-toe in global thermonuclear war? Yes, Congressman, that was the primary purpose of Joshua. And yes, so a million times Joshua has played thermonuclear war against itself, and it has never learned a lesson. Why on this day did Joshua learn a lesson? Perhaps it would be evolution in action, Congressman.